Amen. Are you grateful today? Are you grateful today? Thank you, choir. Thank you. If you're here today, you ought to just say, I'm grateful. A lot of folk can't be here. Amen. There were folk here last week. Some can't be here today. Somebody's going on. Amen. Amen. Somebody had a rough week. Amen. But he woke you up this morning. You ought to be grateful. Let me tell you something. It took me a while to get here today. Looked like everything was happening. This has been a hectic week, but it's been a good week. Amen. Amen. It's a funny thing. The prayer list I had last week, the last ones on the prayer list, I had down pray for me and my children. And I said, I can pray for me. Amen. But pray for me and my children. Amen. Along with all the rest of them on the prayer and healing list. Sister Betsy Campbell is in Grandview Hospital. Had surgery on her spine. Somebody came into Walmart on the phone, you know, folk crazy on the phone, didn't even see her, just ran into her and knocked her down. Messed up her spine. Amen. Keep praying for Sister Phyllis Lane. I didn't check to see whether she's going home. She's been in ICU this week. Amen. And all the rest of them on the prayer and healing list. Keep praying for Terry Lane. Amen. But it's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. David said, I was just glad when they told me, let's go to the house of the Lord. I was just glad. Amen. I want to read from the Gospel of John, the 5th chapter, the Gospel of John, something we all know, this 5th chapter of John. We're all very familiar with it. Amen. The first 15 verses of John 5. When you find it, say amen. Amen. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having 5 porches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water, and then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was made well of whatever disease he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had already been in that condition a long time, he said to him, do you want to be made well? The sick man answered him, sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I'm coming, another steps down before me. Jesus said unto him, rise, take up your bed and walk. And immediately the man was made well, took up his bed and walked. And that day was the Sabbath. The Jews therefore said to him, who cured? Let me slow down there. The Jews therefore said to him, who was cured? It is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry your bed. Amen? So the guy who was cured, they said, what are you doing carrying your bed? He answered them, he who made me well said to me, take up your bed and walk. Then they asked him, who is the man who said to you, take up your bed and walk? But the one who was healed did not know who it was. For Jesus had withdrawn a multitude being in that place. Afterward, Jesus found him in the temple and said to him, "See, you have been made well, sin no more, lest the worst thing come unto you." The man departed and told the Jews that it was Jesus who made him well. Amen. Amen. It was Jesus who made him well. Amen. I want to look at that sixth verse. Do you want to be made well? That's the New King James Version. The regular King James Version just simply say, do you want to be made whole? And I want to use a subject today. Do you really want it? Do you really want it? Amen? Amen. Do you really want it? You know, the last 2-3 weeks I've been talking in and out interchangeably, dealing with the presence of God, mainly with Moses and with Joshua. If you remember, in the very first chapter of Joshua, that's where I almost wouldn't preach some more today, dealing with the blessings of the Lord in Canaan. But in that first chapter, if you recall, God told Joshua after the death of Moses that Moses is dead. Now therefore arise and go over Jordan, you and all the folk with you. And then he told him, every place that the sole of your foot will tread, I have given you. In other words, you already have it. Amen. You just got to go get it. Amen. You already have it. And he described it, if you remember. And we pointed out the fact that Moses' people stayed in the wilderness for 40 years. And even the children, amen, died in the wilderness. We pointed out that the wilderness was a land of just enough. Amen. And they spent 40 years after being delivered, amen, from Egypt, a type of the world, Pharaoh, a type of the devil, crossing the Red Sea, a type of baptism. Amen. And then they stopped in the wilderness. Amen. We all cross our Red Sea, that's baptism. Amen. We all go into the wilderness, which is the type of the carnal walk, where we are new and we don't know how to walk, amen, in the fullness, amen, of God's blessings, amen. But he wants us to grow in that fullness, amen. And so we see where Moses' people spent 40 years just making it day to day. God got them a little bit, and they came and got it every day. And if they tried to get more than a day's worth, it would mold and ruin, because it's a day-to-day journey. They didn't know how to go get the blessings that were theirs. Amen? Amen? So they didn't really want it. Amen? Because if they really wanted it, amen, when God sent them to spy out the land in Numbers, if you recall, the only people who said, we can do this, amen, if God is with us, was Caleb and Joshua. There were 10 guys who spoke Ebonics and said, we be not able. What it ain't about we be, it's about what God be, amen? And if God say you're able, then you are able, amen? But as a matter of fact, I love that Ephesians 3:20, I believe, it now unto him who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power working in us. And that's why we challenge us, amen, to be filled with the Holy Ghost, amen, amen, because that's the power. You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. He's already in you, amen, when you cross the Red Sea. That was God leading you there. But then Joshua, amen, getting ready to cross Jordan, amen, that's the Spirit coming upon you, where you're going to get more than just enough. You're going to get more than enough. Amen? But he did let him know now, it's already yours, but you got to go and get it. Amen. So here's the question is, and you see that this text we just given you is a classic example individually in the New Testament of what we saw in the Old. Amen. In the Old, you see a nation that wouldn't go and get it. Here you see Jesus asking a man, do you really want it? Amen. Do you really want it? This is a good message for these times that we're in. Okay? Because we're dealing with COVID, and we're dealing with a loss of jobs, we're dealing with illnesses, amen. We're dealing with food shortages, we're dealing with all these kind of things, amen. Shortages in the basics, amen. And Jesus is asking us, like he asked this man, do you really want to be blessed? Amen. Do you really want to be blessed? Amen. Because we spoke a few weeks before those messages that we referred to the last couple of weeks, Proverbs 18:21, death and life is in the power of our tongue. And those folk got what they said. When the peace of people with Moses, who said, we be not able, they died in the wilderness. That's where they died. Their children died in the wilderness. We mentioned the fact that decisions of adults can wreck children's life. They can die with the adults in the wilderness. Amen? Amen, somebody? So this man, we find he had a problem. Amen? He had a health problem. He had a help problem, a health, a help, and a hope. Amen? He had all these problems. Amen? But Jesus come to him, and he looks at the man and say, do you really want to be made whole? Do you really want to be made whole? Amen? You see, let me tell you something. God's commandments are God's enablements. Amen? Amen. If he give you a command, he has an enablement to allow you to meet that command. Amen? Nothing is impossible with God. Amen? And so God tells the man to rise up. Amen? In other words, he tells him to get up. Now, if he tells him to get up, amen, he has an enablement that will allow him to do what he said. Amen? It's like when you talk to folk about tithing, amen? You see folk go all their life. We got folk go all their life and broke and won't tithe. Broke, begging, borrowing, doing all that kind of stuff, amen? Don't ever have anything, but will not tithe, amen? Amen? If God said, I just can't see it right now. When I get to this point, amen, I'm going to do it. Amen. You'll never get to that point. Amen. Because you're stealing from God. Amen. Amen, somebody. And so, as we said, when God gives a commandment, he has an enablement. Amen. And that's why he comes down here and looks at this guy and say, now, do you really want to be made whole? Another example of a story we know is like Peter. You remember when it was storming and they about to go under, and Peter see Jesus walking on the water. He said, Lord, is that you? He said, yeah. And he said, basically, is that really you? And Jesus said, come on out. Amen. Jesus told him to come out there. Amen. He gave him basically a command or invitation, and he gave him an enablement. He went out there and went to walking. Amen. The only time he sunk was when he said, wait a minute. What the heck am I doing out here? And he took his eyes off Jesus, amen, amen, and put it on the storm, amen. And we tell you all the time, amen. Don't keep focusing and looking at the problem, amen. We even told you don't even talk to God about the problem. We told you talk to the problem about God, amen. Tell the problem, whosoever will say to this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea. Doubt not in your heart, but believe the words you say will come to pass. You will have whatever you say. Yes, amen? And so you tell the problem what God said. That's why I ain't none of this on this here, y'all. I'm just letting God, let me make me move. Amen? That's why the Lord tell us to stay in the word. Amen? Amen, stay in the word. This man here, amen, he was getting a word from the Lord. Amen? He was getting a word from the Lord. And that's why we come to church. Amen. To get a word from the Lord. As a matter of fact, you will find that when the man found Jesus later on in the story, he found Jesus down at the church. Jesus was in that when he couldn't find it, and Jesus told him, "Say now you got this, but don't sin no more." Amen. Say, cause it says, you keep on doing that stuff, worse is gonna happen to you. Amen. Let me just jump down there. Can I jump ahead of the story? Amen. I think it's 14. After Jesus found him in the temple and said, "See, you have been made well. Sin no more." That's the worst thing will happen to you. Amen. Because you know, they were mad because he did this on the Sabbath. You know, they were really upset. God had a way of showing us what the real priority is. Did you ever notice, just thinking about it, did you ever notice Joshua with Jericho? He marched around Jericho one time each day. And on the seventh day, the Sabbath day, instead of quitting, he marched seven times. Amen? Amen? Because it's about his word. Joshua, as we told you, Yeshua, Joshua, in the New Testament is Jesus. Amen? The word. And Joshua was a type of Christ. And Jesus was letting them see, even back then, with Moses, y'all couldn't do this because you were under the law. Amen? You had this baptism over here in the water. Amen? But you did not receive the Spirit upon you. You got it in you. So you're doing it day to day. But now Joshua getting ready to cross over Jordan, amen, which is the baptism of the Holy Spirit upon you, the empowering, amen. And when you start walking in power, you're not walking on Sabbath, amen. Because when Jesus came, I'll get this another time. When Jesus came, amen, the Bible says, as it began to come to the end of the Sabbaths, amen, amen, and then he rose not on the Sabbath, but he rose on Sunday, because the Sabbath time was over when Jesus came. Amen. The law was over when Jesus came. Amen. We're under grace now, the unmerited favor. We couldn't keep the law. Amen. Because the law that said if you keep everything but miss one thing, you're not perfect. But Jesus became the perfect sacrifice. Amen. And he moved that thing from Sabbath to Sunday, the Lord's Day. Amen, somebody? He moved it from grace. Amen. Amen. He moved from law to grace. Amen. Law will never save you. Amen. Even Noah, amen, stepping out of his boat, the Bible said he found grace. The boat was a type of grace. Amen. The law killed everybody, but he stepped in the boat by grace. And grace will get you out of it. Amen. Amen. It'll get you from the land of just enough to the land of more than enough. Amen. Moses couldn't take them over because Moses was the lawgiver. And the law won't take you over Jordan. It'll get you over the Red Sea. Amen. Amen. It won't get you over Jordan. Amen. And Moses was a type of Christ because the law won't even get you over the Red Sea. But he could get them there. Amen. But he couldn't get them over where God wants us now, in the land of blessing. Amen, somebody. Amen. Oh, my goodness. Amen. I said, I don't know how to do notes. Amen. As I get older, I do notes. Amen. I don't know how to do them because I go off and leave them. Amen. I'm about through already. Praise God. Amen. So do you really want it? Amen. Now watch. That's what Jesus asked to say. Do you really want to be made whole? Do you really want to be, do you really want it? Do you want to get rid of this thing? Amen? And he's looking at him, and I told you he already had these problems. Health, help, and hope. Amen? And so Jesus just saw him laying there. You know, here's what sin will get to you physically. Amen? It gets to you physically. That's why he told the man, don't sin no more. Amen? But one thing about it, amen, as Jesus was pardoned from this man, when I told you what he said in 5:14, amen, sin no more, lest worse come on you, amen. That was his pardon word to this man. And when you look over in 1 Corinthians 11 and 30, Paul mentioned the same thing, amen, that sin will bring you to a place of ultimate problem, and that's death. That's when he's talking to them about the Lord's Supper, amen. But the man, the guy said, but sir, you don't know my problem. He said, I don't have no man. How many folks, y'all comfortable, by the way? Is it woman up? It is woman up? Okay. He said, I don't have no man. You know, you hear folks saying that now? I mean, isn't that funny? And so many of y'all ladies say that, I don't have no man. And some of y'all sure enough don't. They might be wearing pants, but they sure, y'all sure don't. Amen. Amen. That is a real problem today. That's a flat out problem. That's why kids are dying in the wilderness, because I don't have no man. But what you don't know is, amen, if you got Jesus, that's enough. You know, I don't care what you say, I need me a man. Well, you don't have to have one. Amen. You don't have to have one. Amen. Amen. Most of them breath and riches. Amen. But Jesus, amen, will supply all your needs. Amen. Now unto him who is able, amen, to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask. Amen. He is able. Amen. And listen to this thing. Then he goes further down in supplying your needs. He said, what things soever you desire. Amen. Amen. That's different with speaking to the mountain. Whosoever will say to this mountain, be thou removed, be cast in the sea. Amen. Doubt not in your heart, believe the words you say will come to pass. You're going to have whatever you say. Amen. Well, what you say got to be in line with God, because then God going to back what you say. And then he said, now when you pray, believe you receive. Amen. And once again, you're going to have whatever you say. What things soever you desire, when you pray, amen, believe you're going to receive it, you're going to have them. Amen. God takes you from the position of your needs to your desires. Once again, it's got to be in line with God. You know, you got to speak that word in line with what God say. Amen. It's got to be in line with what God say. Amen. And so Jesus comes to this man, and he diagnoses him. Amen. That's what you come to church for. You want to get a divine diagnosis of what your problem is, what your need is. Amen. And so he looked at the health he needed. Amen. And then the guy says, amen, I don't have nobody to put me in. So now Jesus is saying, okay, not only does he have a health problem, he got a health problem. Amen. Amen. And I said to you, this guy is lonely, amen? That's what happened, amen? When you don't have no man, you're lonely, amen? You're alone, nobody's feeling sorry for you, amen? Nobody is caring for you. And so you just start feeling like, I want this, but I don't have nobody. And Jesus is sitting here every week in church and during the week when you should be meditating daily on his word, as we ask you to do, realizing I do have somebody. You know, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen? And it's not just a saying. You say, but I know, but I want to see somebody. Amen? Amen? You'd be surprised. You can get a relationship with Jesus so strong, you see him. Amen, somebody? You see him. Amen? I know David said in Psalm 142, no man careth for my soul. That's a song we used to sing, does Jesus care? Oh, him, amen. And then they go say, oh yes, he cares, amen. His heart is touched with my grief, amen. He cares, amen. That's why he died for us. That's why he came and blessed us like he did, amen. Because he cares, amen. Somebody, did that make sense to you? He cares, amen, amen. And when you start realizing, amen, that your health, amen, can be taken care of by God, amen, amen. He took our sickness upon him. took our sins upon him. Amen. When you start looking at that, because the devil keep telling you where you're short. Amen. What you didn't do. Amen. We don't get declared saved by what we did. We get declared saved by what Jesus did. He took our sins upon him. Amen. He died for us. Took our sickness upon him. Amen. Then he gave us some directions. Amen. That's why the enemy attacks the home. Amen. Because the home molds the children. The home produces the value of the president. The home produces the values of the teachers in our schools. The home produces the values of the governors, the legislators. Amen. What kind of home did they come up in? Amen. The home produces the kind of ministers that stand up and preach to us and teach us and pray for us and anoint us. Amen. It all start, that's why the enemy knew where to start, right there at the home of Adam and Eve. He said, if I can get them here, I got everything else. I got the church. I got, amen. Look at the monster. Look at the monster that's destroying the Ukraine, bombing children. Amen. Bombing hospitals, bombing civilians, shooting civilians. Amen. One girl, 16-year-old, was riding in the car with their parents. Amen. Just normal people and got shot. Amen. You know, little babies being shot. What kind of home produced that kind of monster? Amen. Amen. Look at some folk in America, politicians admiring a madman like Putin. Amen. What kind of home produced that kind of mentality? Amen. And when you watch people in churches, amen, who promote the kind of people with this kind of a mentality, the kind of people that will juggle laws to cut certain races' ability to vote out, the kind of people that will put laws down that say when folks stand in line, you can't give them water. Amen, amen. What kind of ministers at home produce those kind of ministers that will stand up and act like they don't see what they see, amen, and will say nothing because what they want power, amen. Ain't no power like God's power, amen, amen. Ain't no power like God. If God puts you up, who can put you down, amen? If God is for you, who can be against you? Amen. My Bible say we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. I mean, we serve a God that is God all by himself. Amen. If you got Jesus, amen, you got everything. Amen, somebody. Amen. So this man had no, he thought he had no hope. Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me in the pool while I'm coming, another stepping down before me. He had lost all hope. Amen. Amen. In Ephesians, they speak about that. Amen. Ephesians is one of the great books in the Bible. As y'all know, I preach 40-something messages out of that one book. Amen. Only have six chapters. Amen. It says, having no hope. Amen. And without God in the world, amen. That's what sin does, amen. It messes us up, amen. So this man's diseased body, amen, defiled soul and a dead spirit comes, amen, and he meets Jesus, amen. The Bible calls this, Roman calls this total depravity, amen. You start looking at the book of Romans, it describes a world that's totally depraved, amen. When you look at 2 Timothy, the third chapter, it describes perilous times in a depraved world where they will not endure sound doctrine, but that their own lust, through the heap of themselves, teaching and having itching ears. Itching ears will scratch when you say what they want to hear. We don't come to church to hear what we want to hear. We come to church to hear what we ought to hear. Amen. Because if we hear what we ought to hear and do what we ought to do, everything will be all right. Amen. Amen. And that's so Jesus said, man, dude, he said, listen here, son, do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be made whole? I just want to know, do you want it? Amen. Amen. So he says, after the diagnosis, amen, amen, he gets a word of deliverance, amen. He said, I've been looking at this thing, you need deliverance. Say, rise, take up your bed and walk, amen. It wasn't just some deliverance, amen. It was total deliverance, amen. God, amen, has a deliverance package that is total, amen, amen. He said, he looked at the man and said, amen, do you want to be made whole, amen, amen. All of a sudden, this man started realizing he was in the presence of somebody different. Amen. When you come to church, we talked last week about all the glory of his presence. Amen. There is something about being in the presence of God. Amen. Something about being in the presence of God. Amen. Something about God's presence. Amen. David said, though I walk through the valley in the shadow of death. Amen. Amen. In the shadow of death. Amen. I don't fear no evil. He said, why? Because I'm in the presence of God. Thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Amen. 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 You lay me down in the presence of my enemies. Amen. And fill my cup. Amen. And my cup run over. Amen. And then I'm not running through the valley. I'm walking through the valley. Amen. And that death, amen, I find out there's somebody shadowing me, amen. Somebody's walking with me, amen. And I find out it's death, amen. But then I learn that death is nothing but a shadow. And a shadow can't hurt me, amen. A shadow can't hurt me. When I'm driving down the highway and the big semis come and the sun is shining, amen, the shadow of the truck will hit me, but the shadow can't hurt me. And the fact that there's a shadow means that there was light shining on the truck to make the shadow come over, because there is a sunlight, amen, a S-O-N light in the valley with me and making that truck, amen, that shadow of death, just a shadow. And it can't hurt me. Glory to God. And then every time I feel bad and think I'm too bad to make it, think I'm too sorry and too dirty to make it, two folk come along beside me called goodness and mercy. Amen. And they walk with me, and I find out surely and mercy shall comfort me all the days of my life. And then they let me know I'm just passing through here, because I'm going to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Amen, somebody? Amen, somebody? So Jesus said, take up your bed. Take up your bed. Take up your bed. Amen? Take up your bed. Amen? See, he first told him to rise up. In other words, get up. Amen. Quit laying here. Get out your pity party. Amen. Now let me tell you something. I got all this down here, but here's the short version of this. This is the short version of the message. Amen. I got this morning. The Lord said, now if you run into a tight, you got to hurry up. Say, just take this here. That right there. Rise up, take up, walk up. Amen. Amen. He said, tell them you got to rise up. You can't keep laying there in the pity party. Amen. Amen. That's the first thing you got to do. You got to rise up. I ain't going to pick you up. I'll be there to help you get up, but I ain't going to pick you up. He told Moses folk that. He said, now, I'm going to put some food out here for you. You got to come get it. I ain't going to bring it to you. You got to get off your behind and come out there and get it. I got it laying out there for you. You got to come get it. Amen. I ain't going to give it to you and then come boom feed you too. He said, rise up, get up. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Amen. Amen. Like he told Peter, say, come. Amen. Amen. Peter got up and walked. If you do what I say, you're going to get the blessing. Amen. Amen. I'm getting ready to enable you, but you got to rise up. Amen. I'm getting ready to bless you, but you got to get up. Amen. You can't keep laying there. You got to get up. Amen. I ain't going to pick you up. You got to get up. Amen. So he said, rise up. Amen. Amen. And then the next thing he told him was, amen. Take up your bed. Amen. If you don't take up your bed, you will come right back here and get in it with the same folk, amen, you've been in it with. And you'll be talking that same pity talk, amen. I don't have nobody. You're right. What you laying with is somebody, but there ain't much. Amen. You can do way better. But get that bed that you've been laying with them folk pleading in. I'm asking you, do you want to be made whole? You whining about you don't have. I didn't ask you what you didn't have. You ought to start looking at who you do have. Amen, somebody? You looking around at the wrong stuff. You talking the wrong stuff. You can't rise above that negative confession. Get up and get that bed and take it to the dump. Amen. You are making provision for failure. Amen. You got the same old bed around the same old folks. Looking around whining the same whine. Did you hear me ask you, do you want to be made whole? Do you really want it? You broke, but do you tired? You keep stealing from it. Amen. Do you really want it? I'm going to just finish it off on this right here. Now, y'all know, who be with me all the time, y'all know I'd have a little index card by that side, and I'd have a whole sermon off of it. So here we go. Now, the next thing he said, after rise up, take up, he said, now walk. I mean, God, he's standing there with a bed. What am I going to do now? Walk, stupid. Hey, you ain't got no choice. Well, I can't walk. Yes, you can. Try it. Take a step. Amen. In other words, I ain't going to carry you. Ain't nobody else going to carry you. Amen? Rise up, take up, and walk. Church ought to be full. I'm probably preaching to the wrong folk. I'm giving y'all something to take somebody. Amen? 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 As he began to walk through Jerusalem, the folk were shocked. God wants the glory, y'all. Yeah, if what you're asking for is going to give God the glory, he waiting to do it. You know what I mean? You've been riding around in a hoopty all your life. Amen. God waiting for you to have something better. Amen. Don't go out there and just be stupid and get what you can't afford. Amen. You know, because it ain't going to impress nobody. But God wants it. Beloved, I wish above all things. That's only to the beloved now. What's that? That's 3 John 2, right? Yeah. Above all things, that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. That's your mind. Amen. Amen. And your mind will not prosper correctly unless it's heart directed. If your mind is sending it to the heart, you got the wrong thing there. The mind ain't gonna send the heart the right stuff, cause the mind's not born again. The mind is not born again. Amen. Amen. The heart, which is the spirit, is born again. It's got to direct to the mind. That's the first. That's the first place of the healing. Amen. It's a spiritual healing. Amen. I hit that a few weeks ago, amen. It ain't about the physical, it's about the spiritual. Amen. We think the spirit, the physical is caring. It's caring, amen. It's caring the spiritual. No, the spiritual cares the physical. Amen, somebody? Amen. And when it sends the right signal, amen, amen, the walk gonna be different. I can't go in that's another story. Amen. 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 But Jesus said, you gotta walk, ain't nobody gonna carry you. Amen. You gotta walk, ain't nobody gonna carry you. You gotta walk. Amen. Amen. That's why Paul said, when I'm weak, I'm strong. Amen. When I'm weak, I'm strong, because I'm not dependent on me. Amen. And so after Jesus gives them the diagnosis and then the deliverance, he gives them the direction. I'm sitting now. I got to sit now. Got to go. Amen. That's when because I gave the direction at the beginning almost. Afterward, Jesus finds him in the temple, said unto him, behold, thou art made whole. Sin no more. He said, now listen, brother. You've been blessed. Amen. You've been blessed. You're up to a new level. I'm being glorified because everybody's asking the question, where did this come from? Amen. He said, now don't go back to where you were. You know, a whole lot of God bring us up here, and next thing you know, amen, we'll try to be back where we were. Amen. We'll be back to where we were. Because the devil will keep putting you back down to where you were. Amen. That's why Jesus told him to get rid of that bed, get rid of all that stuff. Amen. And that's why he's telling folks, church ought to be full. Amen. Because God took a lot of folk up. They're going to get the same bed. Amen. And have the same folk in it and everything else in it. Amen. And be right back down where they were. He didn't intend for us to be down there disgracing him, embarrassing him. Amen. Now, let me take that back. Let me take that back. No, we can't embarrass God. let me take that one back. Yeah, yeah. I remember God said to me once, I can't remember what that was. And I said, I can't remember the story that has been so long. But I remember God corrected me so. Because it was something I said I didn't want to do to him. I don't remember. But I remember God correcting me. Like, you can't do. You can't hurt me. You can't do nothing to me. Oh, no. I know I said I didn't want this to happen. You know, like we were growing and all that stuff and all that. I said, you know, I don't want to make you look bad. You know, that's my prayer. God stopped me in my tracks. He said, wait a minute, son. You can't make me. Do you know who I am? You can make you look bad. But you can't make me look bad. So I stopped right there, y'all. God has a sense of humor, but he corrected me real quick. No, you make, you know, think about that. No, he wouldn't make God look bad. He'd make himself like a fool. Amen. And he'd go back to looking like he was looking. But, I mean, it ain't God. You understand what I'm saying? But God wants us to glorify him. He wants to take us to another level. And he wants us to always be looking and seeking and trying to learn more. One of the secrets of God letting me keep as a pastor, I believe, as a minister, is and most old preachers quit learning. They quit studying. They quit learning. They quit bringing new stuff, you know what I mean? It's like I talk about the baptism of the Spirit all the time. That's way new, amen? There's zillions of guys written books and some of everything and haven't seen the simplicity of that. And I know how simple it is because I taught what they taught for years because it's the denominational belief. Amen? But it's so clear when you start saying just the Spirit upon, the Spirit within. I mean, just those two words. It's there everywhere. It's the same thing everywhere. But if you don't want to believe it, you won't believe it. But you can't deny it. Nobody ever calls me and argue me when they hear me making those points. You know, nobody. Because you can't deny it. It's there. You know what I mean? God wants to take us to another level. He never wants to stop taking us to another level. And I don't care where you are now, that's another level. I don't care how things look now, that's another level. I'm going to sit down now. I'm through. Amen? That's another level. Amen? So he gave this, after he got this guy to this point, when we get these blessings, you know, we got a tendency, we'll start feeling like we're so smart and we're so whatever, we don't need God no more. Amen? Look at the church. Look at the attendance in the church and all. Amen? Amen? Because this is another story, but the Bible, we taught you that for 50-some years. Apostasy is going to happen in the last days, and it'll be more and more falling away. Amen? But he gave him this direction. Amen? He said, go and sin no more. Amen? He found him in the temple, and he told him that. Amen. Give him two things to do. Amen. And the main thing was, go and sin no more. Don't do this no more. Don't do it no more. Amen. Let your life be a life that glorify me. That's all I'm going to say. Amen. Because it's time for me to cut this thing off. But there's another whole point there in this thing, in the direction. Go and sin no more. Amen. And where he was in church. Amen. That's why he was talking to the man. He was right at church. Amen. That's why the church exists. Jesus wasn't talking to somebody out there. He was talking to this guy. Amen. And the church exists for us to keep on being reminded of what God is wanting us to do what God has for us to do, and then we go out and get some folk and bring them in here and teach them and send them back out. So the world just keep on seeing, amen, that Jesus is real. Amen. That's what 1 John 5 and 13 say, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life. Amen. He came to make us whole, my little message here said. Amen. And the secret of success is keeping our eyes on Jesus. Amen. Keep our eyes on Jesus. Now I'll close with this. I got here to live a life of radiant victory. Sin no more. Amen. Amen. He not only gives that command, I said, but he also enables us to keep it. Amen. For sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under the law, but under grace. Romans 6:14. Thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ. Y'all know that's a favorite. That's on me and my wife's headstone. Amen. This right here. Thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ. 2 Corinthians 2:14. Y'all know I love that. In all these things, I've already mentioned that we are more than conquerors. Romans 8:37. Amen. Amen. The victorious life. Amen. The victorious Christian life is the victorious Christ in us. Amen. The life of faith is a life of utter dependence on the Lord Jesus Christ to do in and through us what we cannot achieve of ourselves. Amen. God bless you. Do you really want it? Amen. I don't care how much of it you have, there's more of it available. Let's be greedy in a positive way and say, Lord, I want all of you I can have. I want to show the world, amen, what it's like to be your child. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what you're going through. You're going through it. You're not gonna stay there. I don't care how bad the news is. I've done something this week that I don't remember ever doing. I taped the news from 5 to 7 every week. Since my 20s, people used to know they always catch me at home from 5 to 7, catching the news. Josh Daddy Greg is the same way. He's almost a carbon copy of me. You know, Greg got radios in the bathroom. Always had a bathroom when I was a radio. Folks knew that's not the bathroom, nobody go there. You know, I had books, all that, you know. But this past week, I got something looking at what they're doing to those people, Russia, that I just didn't look for a couple of days. You know, it's terrible. God is still God. I don't care how bad things look in America for us, God is still on the throne. Do you really want it? It's available for you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Amen. It's good. I love the part about he gives the command and he gives the enable. Amen. Whatever he tells you to do, he'll enable us to do it if we got the faith. Thank you, Lord, for your word today. We really want it, Lord. Not for our glory, but for your glory. Let us know it's not our will, it's your will. You said in your word, whatever you ask according to my will, I'll do it. If you abide in me, my words abide in you. Ask what you will, it shall be done unto you. Bless us, O God, with an excitement about coming into your presence. Amen. Every week I find an excitement of coming into your presence. Through the week, amen, I change the routine. Amen. We get up for about an hour of praising you. Amen. In the morning. Amen. We don't look at the TV and look at the sports like I was doing. We cut on some praise and we have a time praising you, and the day just goes better. Amen. It just goes better when I'm riding with you. Amen. It just goes better when we're praising with you and we're experiencing the moving of your spirit. We're experiencing the filling, oh God. Let us seek you, knowing if we seek you, we'll find you. If we knock, doors will be open. We surrender our lives to you. We surrender our talent, our time, our tithe to you. We just thank you, Lord. Bless America. Bless the world. Bless the people in the Ukraine. Bless us, oh God, in the church. Let us seek you, knowing if we seek you, we'll find you. Let us knock at your doors, dear Lord, knowing that if we knock, you will open. Open our hearts that we receive the moving of your Spirit, that we receive your word, that we receive the challenge, dear God, to go to another level, knowing that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Bless your word today. Let it fall on fertile ground. Say that you're a thief and a liar. We are going to take your hands off the people of God. Take your hands off of their homes, out of their homes, off of their health, off of their finances, off their children, off of their jobs, off of their property, off of whatever you got a hold of. We have authority over you. We use it in the name of Jesus. We've been praying for people's homes, for people's parents, for people's children. Whatever is on our prayer list, whatever we send up to you, corporately and individually, we ask you, Lord, that you start moving on it right now. Satan, again, you're a liar. We come against you in the name of Jesus. Bless now, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Is there somebody today that need to come?